Welcome to part four of the Brightspace Foundations training, where we will talk about the three primary assessment tools in Brightspace: assignments, discussions, and quizzes. Up first, we have assignments. Assignments are used when you want students to submit some work through Brightspace. Instead of having students turn in homework or papers in person, you can have them submit online and save you the headache of managing loose papers. Start by navigating to the module where you want to add an assignment. Click Upload Create, and select New Assignment from the drop-down menu. This is the assignment creation page. The default type of assignment is a file submission, which is an assignment where the student is expected to upload and submit a file, such as a Word document. First, give your assignment a name. Use a name that is clear to the student. Second, determine whether you want the assignment to be connected to the gradebook. Click on Ungraded to enter a points value and add it to the gradebook. Third, add a due date if there is one. This due date will show up in the course calendar, making it easy for students to see when something is due. Fourth, add the assignment instructions or upload any pertinent files. Finally, if you're ready for it to be visible to students, toggle the visibility icon and click Save and Close. These five steps are the basic steps for creating an assignment in Brightspace. There are additional settings in the accordion menus to the right, which I won't go through in detail, but I will talk about briefly. In availability dates and conditions, you can set a start and end date for the assignment. This is when students can access the assignment. If no start and end dates are set and the assignment is visible, then students can access it anytime. Set an end date if you don't want students to submit after a certain date. Having just a due date set lets students submit late work after that date, but setting an end date limits or ends their access to the assignment. In submission and completion, you can change the assignment type. As mentioned previously, the default assignment type is a file submission, where students are required to upload a file to complete the assignment. However, in this accordion menu, you can choose from several more options. A text submission, which allows students to type directly into Brightspace instead of uploading a file, or even an on-paper submission or an in-person observation, both of which do not allow students to submit anything to the assignment, but they are essentially just used for instructions. These types are not regularly used. Finally, in evaluation and feedback, you can create and attach an existing rubric or enable Turnitin, which is a plagiarism checker. Once you click Save and Close, your assignment will show up in the content module where you created it. Pause the video now and try your hand at creating an assignment in your course. For this example, create a module called Assignments, then create a new assignment called Assignment and make it worth 10 points. Make sure you also add it to the gradebook. When you're finished, toggle the visibility and click Save and Close. The assignment will appear in content in the module where you created it. Now that you've created your own example assignment, it's important for you to understand the student's experience. Your assignment will appear in the content module where you created it. Students will click on the assignment link to access the submission page. The instructions you add will appear at the top of the page, and the upload box will appear at the bottom. For a file submission assignment, like this one, students have to complete their assignment outside of Brightspace, such as in a Word document, and then they will click Upload on this page to find the file saved on their computer and upload it. Then they will click Submit. The student will get an email letting them know they submitted the assignment. Grading assignments. There are a couple different ways to access student submissions, but we will just go over two here: the assignment tool and the grades tool. The first way is through the assignment tool. Click on Assessments and select Assignments from the nav bar, or you can also get here from Course Admin. Then click on the drop-down arrow next to the assignment name and select View Submissions. On the Submissions page, click on the file link for each student in order to view their submission. Add a grade and publish your feedback and score in order for students to see it. Another way you can grade an assignment is through the Grades tool. You can only grade from here if you added your assignment to the gradebook. Click on Assessments and then select Grades from the nav bar, or you can also get there from the course admin. In the assignment column, you will see this icon, which represents a student's submission. If there is no icon, the student has not submitted anything yet. Click on the icon to view the submission. The same submission screen will open for you to grade the student's work. Add a grade and publish your feedback and score for students to view. You can move on to the next student's submission using the arrows at the top. Just a note, if a student submitted multiple files, you can view each of them from the drop-down here. The next tool we will cover is the Discussions tool. Discussions in Brightspace are typically used for students to engage in discourse with one another. In a general sense, it is a space for students to respond to a prompt from you and then reply to each other's responses. It can also be used like the assignment tool for file or text submissions, but its biggest advantage is that students are able to see each other's work and can respond to it. Start by navigating to the content module where you want to add the discussion topic. Click Upload, Create, and select New Discussion from the drop-down menu. This is the discussion topic creation page. But before we jump into creating our first discussion topic, I want to talk about two terms when it comes to discussions: forums and topics. Forums can be thought of as categories. They are essentially a container used to group topics together. A topic is the actual area students engage with to submit their threads or posts. You can have one forum for all your discussion topics, or you can create a unique forum for each topic. But every topic must have a forum. So in essence, topics are what students actually respond to, while forums are just containers or categories for the topics. Now that we understand these two differences, we can continue. As we said, this is the discussion topic creation page. To begin, you will add a title for the topic. This is similar to what we did for assignments. This could be as simple as discussion one, or it could be more specific to the topic itself, such as introduction discussion. If you want to grade the discussion, click on Ungraded and enter your possible points and click Add to Gradebook. Notice there isn't a due date option for discussions like we had for assignments. This is intentional. In Brightspace, discussion topics do not have due dates. This is because oftentimes instructors will use two due dates for discussions: the date by which the initial post must be completed and the date by which the replies to other students must be completed. Because of the inability for Brightspace to support two different due dates, they simply just don't have the option. The description area is where you will add the instructions for this discussion topic. Be specific about what you want the student to do. For example, if you are creating an introduction discussion where you want students to introduce themselves to the class, your instructions should be clear and specific. Moving on to the rest of the settings. Just like for assignments, the accordion menus on the right contain additional optional settings. Availability dates and conditions is where you can set certain end dates for the discussion topic. Under post and completion, you can adjust settings such as allowing anonymous posts where students' names are not visible to other students, or requiring students to post their initial response before they are able to view and reply to other student threads. And finally, evaluation and feedback is where you can create and attach a rubric, as well as set other settings such as ratings. As we also did with assignments, set the item to visible and click Save and Close. Now it's your turn. Pause the video so you can try your hand at creating your first discussion topic activity. In Content, add a new module called Week 2. Create a new discussion called Discussion 1, make it worth 10 points, and add it to the gradebook. When you are finished, save it and return to Content. It should look like this when you are finished. Now let's talk a moment about the student experience. The students will click on the discussion topic from where you added it to Content. Remember, they can also get there from the discussion tool. After reading the instructions, they click Start a New Thread to post to the discussion topic. The subject and body will appear below the instructions on the same screen, ready for students to type directly on the screen. Students will add a subject and then type the response into the editor before clicking Post to submit it. Replying to students' submissions can also be hard to figure out, but it's a necessary component, so we are covering it here. This would be the same process for you as the instructor to reply to a student's threads. In order to reply to a thread, click on the subject or title of the thread. Below the thread, you will see the button called Reply to Thread. The reply text box will appear on the same screen, ready for students to type the reply. Click Post to submit it. Grading. There are a couple different ways to grade student threads, but by far the easiest way is via the Grades tool. So that's the way we will show you today. A quick note, to simply view and interact directly with the students' discussions, go directly to the discussion topic where you can see the entire discourse. Click on Assessments and then Grades from the nav bar, or you can also get there from Course Admin. In the grade column for the discussion item, you will see this icon, which represents a student's submission. If there is no icon, the student has not posted anything yet. Click on the icon to view the submission. The submission screen will open for you to grade the student's work. You will be able to see the number of threads and replies the student has posted, as well as their initial post and the replies to other students, all in one place. View their work, add a grade, and publish your feedback and score for students to view. You can move on to the next student submission using the arrows at the top. The last tool we'll go over in this recording is the quizzes tool. Quizzes in Brightspace are typically used for just that, quizzes, exams, tests. However, they can also be used for any activity in your course that has the potential to be auto-graded. In that respect, a quiz can be used for end-of-chapter questions, a tool for students to test their own knowledge, class worksheets you once handed out in person that would require individual grading, any activity that involves answering questions that are multiple choice, true, false, matching, fill in the blank, short answer, etc., are all good for quizzes. Quizzes can be timed or untimed, can be set to one attempt or multiple attempts, can be auto-graded or manually graded, and most importantly, can save you time. To create a quiz, start by navigating to the module where you want to add the quiz. Click Upload Create and select New Quiz from the drop-down menu. You'll notice the interface is relatively consistent with the assignment and discussion tool. Start by giving your quiz a name, such as Chapter 1 Quiz. Next, determine whether you want the quiz to be connected to the gradebook. Click on Not in Gradebook and select Add to Gradebook to create an associated grade item with the same name. The points will auto-calculate as you add questions to the quiz. Third, you can add a due date if there is one. This due date will show up in the course calendar, making it easy for students to see when the quiz is due. As a reminder, the due date does not restrict access to the quiz, it simply provides students with the date in which they are supposed to complete the quiz. You'll use the other settings on the right to determine access and time limits. Finally, in the top section, you can add a description for your quiz. The description are instructions that your students will see before they enter the quiz. Under the description is where we have our question canvas. To start adding questions, select Create New, then New Question, and then select the question type you want for your first question. There are a few question types. Most of us are familiar with these various types of questions, but you can explore each of them to learn more. Once you have added all of your questions, you can finish the rest of the settings using the accordion menus on the right. In Availability Dates and Conditions, you can set a start and end date for the quiz. This is when students can access or begin the quiz. In the Timing and Display section, you can determine how many questions per page you want to appear, as well as whether the quiz is timed, and if so, how much time is allotted, and what you want the system to do once the timer expires. In the Attempts and Completion section, you can set more than one attempt if you choose. Finally, in Evaluation and Feedback, you can select what you want the students to see after they submit their quiz. Once you are done with your settings, you can change the visibility of the quiz and click Save and Close. Now it's your turn. In Content, add a new module called Exams. Create a new quiz called Midterm Exam. Make it worth 50 points and add it to the gradebook. Create at least two questions so you get the feel of that experience. When you are finished, change the visibility and click Save and Close. Your quiz will now appear under Content in the module you added it to. Now let's take a look at the student experience. Students will access the quiz from the Content module where you added it, or they can also access it from the nav bar under Assessments and Quizzes. The first screen they see is a summary and start page. This is where any instructions you include in the description will appear. It will also provide them with details of the settings you set, such as the time limit and number of attempts. When they're ready, they will click Start Quiz. The timer starts as soon as they click Start Quiz. The quiz will appear like this. A list of question numbers show on the left, and the questions appear on the right. By default, all the questions will appear on one page. Their answer selections save automatically. Once they are done, they click Submit Quiz. There is one more quiz confirmation screen to ensure they are really ready. They can either go back to the questions to review again or click Submit Quiz. By default, once they submit, they will see their overall percentage or score on the quiz. They will not see what they got right or wrong unless you set up those settings under the evaluation and feedback area of the quiz editing screen. Finally, let's see how we as instructors view the students' attempts. Quizzes for the most part are automatically graded, making it easy to view student scores in one place. There are two primary ways to see the student attempts on quizzes: the quizzes tool and the grades tool. To view the quiz attempts from the quizzes tool, go to Assessments and then Quizzes on the nav bar. You can also get here from Course Admin. Click on the drop-down arrow next to the quiz title you want to view and select Grade from the menu. You will see a list of your students who have completed the quiz and their score. Click on the link for Attempt 1 to view their completed quiz. Just a reminder, students are not able to see their completed quiz or what they got right or wrong on it unless you set that setting for them. But if you are meeting one-on-one with a student, this is an easy way to show them their quiz attempt from your view. The other way you can view all the students' scores on a quiz as well as their attempts is from the Grades tool, assuming you added it to the gradebook. From the nav bar, select Assessments and then Grades. You can also get here from Course Admin. Find the column for the quiz to view the scores. This question mark icon represents a completed quiz or a quiz in progress. Click on the quiz attempt icon for the student you wish to view. In the pop-up window, select Attempt 1 from the Attempt drop-down menu. This concludes the video on assignments, discussions, and quizzes. Take some time to review the things you learned and practice creating these items in your course. We'll see you in the next video.